We need to formalize how we will precisely measure each type of variability. We already decided that we're going to use the grand mean and use the same idea as standard deviation to measure the spread of these sample means. We'll find each squared deviation from the mean, and in this case, we're going to multiply each squared deviation by the sample size. Each squared deviation is equivalent to the area of each of these squares. And then we'll multiply this area by the respective sample size. Here, k represents the number of samples. That means we'll have k sample means. And then we'll add them all up. In this lesson, though, we're assuming that all samples have the same size. So we can get rid of the k. N is just a constant across all samples. That means that we can write the numerator between group variability like this. And then we divide by the degrees of freedom. When we say formal way of measuring something, that means we get one number. If we add up each squared deviation of each sample mean from the grand mean, multiply this by the sample size, and then divide by the degrees of freedom, we get one number that describes between group variability. We need to do the same for within group variability. And we'll do something similar to the way we measured between group variability. We'll take the sum of squares for each individual sample from the mean of each sample, and then we divide by the degrees of freedom. What do you think the degrees of freedom is in this case? Let's say that we have three samples. More than one option may be correct.